Installing the ESP IDF for Windows has really become simple. For starters, we're going to be going over to the ESP IDF documentation. And on the homepage, I'm going to click on this Getting Started link. And then down on the side over here, I'm going to be looking at installation step by step. And then over here, I'm going to click on the Windows icon. The ESP IDF used to only work on Linux, and we used to have to download a tool called MySys32, which acts as a shell within Windows in order to run the ESP IDF. Luckily, we don't need to do that anymore. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be going through to this ESP IDF tools installer, and we're going to download this over here. Once it's completed downloading, go ahead and start the wizard. Accept the license agreement. And over here, you'll notice that it is asking you which version of Python you wish to use. At the moment, I have this one installed, so I'm just going to go ahead and use that one. Now, if you already have Git installed, which is a repository for storing source code, which is where the ESP IDF resides, you have the option of actually getting a copy of Git if you don't have it. Otherwise, you can use the one that you already have on your computer. I already have Git installed, so I'm just going to go ahead and select this first option. Now, as this is the first time I'm installing the ESP IDF, I'm just going to go ahead and choose Download ESP IDF. Very importantly, do not choose anything less than version 4 for this course. You can try to use the master branch, which is ahead of version 4, but for now, I'm going to use this release for version 4.0, which is a stable branch. Now, very importantly, we're going to be looking at where we want to actually keep the ESP IDF on our machine. What I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up my Explorer, and then in my C drive, I'm going to create a new directory called ESP. Now, there are two things that we want to install in this directory. The first thing is the ESP IDF. So let's go ahead and create a directory for that. The next thing I want to install in this directory is the toolchain. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click over here, create a new folder, and just add a tools directory. With this ESP directory and its two subdirectories created, let's go back to the installer and let's select where we would like to install the EIDF, which will be under this PC, C, ESP, ESP IDF. Next, it's going to be asking us where we want the ESP IDF tools, which is going to be where we're going to be keeping the toolchain, the extension toolchain that comes with the ESP. I'm going to go Browse, ESP Tools. Click Next, and then click Next again. And install. Once the ESP IDF wizard is complete, it'll ask whether you wish to run the ESP IDF command prompt. It's a good idea to go ahead and test everything, so let's go ahead and make sure that is selected and click Finish. Now, if everything works, you should see something like this, where we're importing all of the various different environment variables into this particular shell. Now, it's opened up this directory in ESP ESP IDF, which is perfect. So if we go ahead and actually have a look at what's in here by typing dir, we should see an examples folder. Let's go into that directory. And then typing dir again, we should see something called get started. Let's go ahead into that. And finally, in this directory, we'll look at the Hello World project. Now, in order to test that our IDF installation has worked correctly, we're going to type the following command. IDF.py is the tool that we use for doing all sorts of things with controlling the ESP32, including flashing, monitoring, and various different other commands. In this particular case, what I want to do is I want to make sure that I've got the port. So I'm going to say minus P, and in this case, it's COM5. If you do not know which port your chip is on, the way that we can figure out which port our device is on is by going through to the device manager by clicking on the Windows and then looking for device manager. And then scrolling down here, you under ports, expand that. And you can see over here that you should have something like a UOS bridge or something like that. If you're uncertain, what you can do is simply unplug the chip. And you'll notice that it actually disappears. Let's put it back again. And here you can see it's on COM5. So my command is going to be idf.py minus p COM5. And then what I want to do is I want to be able to flash this chip. And at the same time, I want to monitor it. Monitor is going to give me the serial output coming from the chip, while flash is just going to dump whatever is in there into the chip. Now the initial build, which this does as well, does take a couple of minutes. So you can see over here that it's flashed the chip, and now it's printing the output of that chip. So what it's doing is it's just saying hello world. It's saying this is the ESP32, it's two CPUs, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, low energy, the silicon reversion, as well as the amount of flash available. And then it just goes ahead and does a count and restarts. Seeing this output is proving that this particular application is running on the chip. We'll get more into details about what's involved with this particular application at a later point, but for now, everything seems to be working fine.